On the 25th of May 2020, African-American George Floyd was killed during an arrest by the police force of Minneapolis. A white police officer knelt on Floyd's neck for a period of 8 minutes and 46 seconds. After his death, protests against police brutality, especially towards black people, quickly spread across the globe. Every country dealt with it on its own way if we look to media and news coverage. That was also the fact in Belgium and Serbia. Two different countries, two different sorts of processing the news and the upcoming Black Lives Matter movement. Serbian professor of history Olivera Vidovic says that because of the unstable economy, Serbia through history was never a target country of extra-continental migrations.
The values of anti-fascism emphasized in the contemporary history of former Yugoslavia, as well those of the brotherhood and unity, fell into a crisis in the last decades of the 20th century. The religious and national intolerance appears as a burning question. However, it was directed towards the Balkan region rather than racial groups.
Regardless of the fact that there are not many African Americans in Serbia, she says that it is extremely important to draw parallels in the media and in education with European countries that have racial intolerance directed at African Americans.
History professors faced problems when trying to find domestic media sources related to the fight against the racism and Black Lives Matter movement.
The contrast between Serbia and Belgium is huge. In Belgium, there were many protests in different cities. Tens and thousands of citizens gathered to shout against police violence. According to Belgian freelance journalist and musician Peter Beda, the Belgian media covered the story with the wrong intentions.
I think they try to give a voice to certain people that organized the Black Lives Matter in Brussels, but then it's very hard because it's just an item that lasts for a couple of days or maybe 1 week, and the media picks a person that's available to talk about it, and it doesn't necessarily mean that this person is really representing the whole movement, or I think it's very complex and it should be handled in a complex way. Of course, that's not really the way that media works. So a lot of people were motivated to come to the protest, and protest is very peacefully, and the idea that such a strong part of the population took to the streets is really very important. But of course the media only focused on one thing, which is like the riots that took place just after the protest was finished. So this is, and then also in a manner that's without any criticism, without any background, without any context.
In Serbia, there was a small amount of 15 activists at the Black Lives Matter protest. Citizens were holding up banners of support in English and Serbian language. Activist of the organization Woman in Black, Milos Urošević, who participated in these protests, says that he was not surprised by the small number of protesters and that everything went smoothly.
We feel it is our civic responsibility to respond with injustices occur around the world, even though some of them have nothing to do with the country in which we live. But we can also draw a parallel between the position of Afro-Americans population in United States and that of the Roma minority in Serbia.
He believes that the right-wing politicians, but also the political leadership of Serbia, which has a fascist background, directly influences the reporting of the Serbian media on Black Lives Matter protests in the world.
Some media that are close to us in terms of values portrayed the protests as they really are, and those who are close to the ruling regime in Serbia were certainly on the side of the white American police. I'm not sure how much they understand the importance of the protest in the general, which emphasized the message that the life of black people are as important as value of the life of white people.
We also asked the Belgian organizer of the Black Lives Matter protest, Anis Agris, if he thinks that the Belgian media covered the manifestations in a reasonable way.
No, actually not. They were clearly looking for sensation. With the organization Belgium Youth Against Racism, we organized 5 protests in 5 different cities in 5 days, which I think is very impressive because we didn't have any experience with the organization of protests. We made it anyway, so we did a good job. But the entire news segment of these protests has been completely ignored by drawing attention to the riots in Brussels and the arrests in Antwerp. And that's a pity, because the actual message of the protest is completely lost in that way.
Agri says that the media just want to collect the biggest audience as possible. He uses the case of Leopold II, a Belgian king who's known for his brutal slavery and inhuman actions towards the citizens of Congo in the 19th century.
The problem with the media is sometimes we say we want statues of Leopold II in musea and not on the street. Well, the only thing I read in the headlines is the people of Youth Against Racism want the statues gone. But that's completely not what I said. But that's the thing with the media. They're searching for clicks and sensation. Most people only read the title and not the content of the article, and that's a real problem.
As we see, there are many differences in media coverage of the Black Lives Matter movement. News companies are processing the object variously due to different approaches and ethnic diversity under the citizens of Serbia and Belgium.